Hello friends and family, and welcome to my channel. My name is Magnus and the channel name is Green Machine Sweden. Today I'm going to repot my Dawn redwood forest. It's purchased by me in a normal garden center 1.5 years ago, I think. And it's still in that organic soil that it came with. I see a lot of people that get new trees from garden center and they immediately put it into a granular mix. However, I do it different. The organic soil may not be the best soil for long-term success in bonsai. However, the trees are produced in it and they can very well grow in it for a few years. So for me, it's more important to learn the new species, try to see how it grows, what demands it has on conditions and so on. And the soil can be changed later. The Dawn redwood have this challenge that they grow a big leaf and it really needs to expand quite long. And later it hardens and becomes a new branch. And when planting this tight, I don't see any possibility to really develop a nice branch structure on it. So I really think that this is too tight and too small space for this kind of species. The best way would probably be to get them out of the pot, separate them, put them into one big container each and grow them for a while to develop and then later put them together into a forest. However, I have this challenge with the space in here. I cannot fit five big pots, so I've been looking around and I found this slightly bigger pot to put them in, and I think it's gonna be at least a little bit easier to develop it. The Dawn redwood is a very heavy root grower. I have been cut out roots growing from the drainage holes, and I think that that one came out quite easy. There you see, quite a lot of roots, isn't it? I don't understand why organic soil is, why everyone think it's bad for the tree. It's not perfect for developing a nice root system, but it definitely is not a health problem for the trees, at least not under my conditions, I would say. Yeah, I think this is going to be quite a challenging repot. There's five trees with the roots totally tangled into each other. But yeah, I'm gonna start with it and see where we land. Yeah, I think those circling roots on the close to the pot, to the rim of the pot, it's not possible to save, so I need to find a way to just cut it out. Let's see if a normal scissor would do. I don't like to destroy my expensive tools with these kinds of operations. Seems like it's more roots than soil actually. And I noticed that the soil has been running out the drainage hole, so I have big holes in there. I'm not sure here. It's a really mess of roots here. I think this takes some quite serious root pruning. I think this is the only way to get them separated, really. Okay, here comes the root scissors. And I'm trying to get into the root system now. Trying to be gentle with the roots that are left. Like the really big ones growing in the bottom doesn't seem to make any difference. So, looking from above, I have really hard to identify a good root flare here. But I know that there are like too heavy on one side, so I guess at least for this tree, I'm gonna build a new root structure from the fine fibrous roots. Yeah. So that's about the process. I'm gonna take them one by one, and if I find something interesting, I will show you. This one really have a few roots that I think I can use. This one maybe. It's a thick root. I think if I just cut it back at some place where it branches. Yeah, that's a second tree. Let's move on. Yeah, look at this. It's totally full with clay in the root base, and yeah, really mess to clean up. It's like a lot of it, and it's really, really heavy clay. Exciting how they produce cheap trees, and I guess you get what you pay for, right? On this one I noticed the heavy roots in the bottom have been growing along the bottom of the pot. If I just stop them from circling, maybe in the future I can lift the tree and use these ones, but they need to be shortened. Yeah, looking for where it branches. That's quite far out, but anyway, Yeah, I'm always a little bit scared when I do this root pruning, especially since it's a new species for me. So here's a look at the carnage before I start to clean up here and put it into a pot. It seems like it's more roots than substrate. Anyway, let's clean this mess up and I get back to you. Okay, so all these trees, I talked about how hard it is to grow new branches, and it's really all these trees have grown several leaders. Yeah, that's only the only space it have had to grow proper branches. And I thought, like, yeah, they should be quite easy to propagate by hardwood cuttings. So I'm gonna choose for each of the trees a new leader. And for this one, I'm quite sure that I want to grow the tallest one. Yeah. Oh, that's a ugly cut. But they need to be done, I think. It's growing and there's a bulge here. I really think I need to cut a quite big cut like this and hope that it heals. Something like that. So, that's one tree, and the second one is not that bad really, if I go for this as a new leader. This one I can remove here like so, and it splits into two more. Now I have the wound on the back side, but this one, yeah, I'm gonna go for the smallest one to create a little bit of tapering, like so. This one have three leaders and very, very close to each other. Yeah, it seems like this one is a little bit further down than the other two. Yeah, I don't know. No matter how I do this, it's gonna look a little bit ugly for a while. I will go for the lower, thinner one. Here comes a really big cut. Let's take it in sections. Yeah, this one was a little bit scary. But if it heals up, it's gonna look good. Like so. Another crazy one. This one can just be removed. I don't want that one. And I see that there's so much more tapering going on in this branch than the other one. I'm gonna take this one off and trying to make another angled cut like so. This one I think needs to be quite big cut as well, or maybe not. Maybe if I just remove this one and make an angle cut for this one like so, we have a one trunk tree again. Yeah, I don't know. up here, it could be a new canopy, but yeah, we shot in this one like so. Yeah, I have been tying in forests before, and once you need to take the wire out of the root ball, it's really, really hard and very easy to forget a few pieces, and it makes a mess. So for this forest, I'm planning to put them in the pot without tying them in, and I'm gonna keep them here in the greenhouse so they don't wiggle in the wind. Yeah, they should grow roots quite fast, so after midsummer somewhere I probably can move them out. It makes sense to start with the biggest and thickest in the front, and I want to avoid symmetry, so I want, there's another one with thick trunk, maybe even like so, and the two smallest ones. Yeah, I'm gonna place the branch facing outwards. Something like this. I'm gonna see from the front, they look like they are a little bit too straight. You need to see both of them like so. And I figure creating something with two separate trees quite close to each other here, and let's see the distance here, maybe this one, like a group of three and a group of two. Yeah, I have done a few forests, and all the time I think it's a mess to get them to stand exactly where you want, and filling up soil and stuff. But I think we have something here, so I'm gonna fill up with soil now. Yeah, I'm trying to adjust this last little parts like so. So this is the finished view for now, or should I say semi-finished, because in 1 year from now I hope they have developed a lot more, and that I have a lot of hardwood cuttings that I can add to the composition to make it a more of a dense forest. So I really hope that this will make the trees develop a little bit better. And as I said, 1 year from now I will redo the work again. If you don't want to miss that, you know that you can always hit that subscribe button. Thanks a lot for watching. Take care. Stay safe. Bye.